Welcome back to Let's Play Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Knuckles. In the last episode, we beat Carnival Night Zone, and in the next episode, we'll take on Ice Cap Zone and the final level of the Sonic 3 portion of the game. So let's get right to it. Let me turn on the game audio. Well, actually, no. Let me unpause the game. So basically, we're going to jump into this balloon, and we're going to launch ourselves or get launched to the next level, which is Ice Cap Zone. Now, the opening sequence for Ice Cap Zone is different between Sonic and Tails. If you're Sonic, you'll be riding on a snowboard. If you're Tails, you'll just be falling into the wall. I guess Sega didn't think Tails was cool enough to ride a snowboard, but oh well, it's a shame. It would've been cool to see him riding on a snowboard in the first opening sequence. Here we got enemies similar to those in Sonic the Hedgehog 1's Labyrinth Zone. They'll basically be shooting their spikes at you, wait for them to go, and you should be fine. And here you can already find a special Sage Ring. So this is your snow level of the game. Not too difficult at all. You can ride this ice block as a walk, I'm gonna get squashed. As a sled. Fun fact, when I was a kid, I never got to this level because as I mentioned in the previous video, was never able to get through that drum part. I was such a dumbass. Interesting fact! Your fire shield or lightning shield will actually melt the spikes of the badneck here, so yeah. You can actually jump into them. This will be my third favorite zone of the game, or at least the Sonic 3 portion of it. Good music. I don't really care for the background in Act 1, but the background in Act 2 is pretty nice. Break the ice and get the ring box. Do not stand under these gusts of cool air because it'll be frozen and you'll get hurt. And do not jump those icicles until they're all the way down. So now I just lost a shield, which is awesome. Which means I'm gonna have to go into a bonus stage to get a shield. Yeah, we can go to the Glowing Spears one. You can tell which bonus stage will come about. If the stars are red, it'll be this one. If the stars are white, it'll be the Gumball Machine one. Or if the stars are orange, it'll be the Casino one. So that's how I knew which one to jump into. I really could use a shield here. A shield would be really nice right now. And unfortunately, I don't get the shield. We're launched way too far. Well, that's awesome. Alright. So, these rings will actually produce about 80 rings. Those ring bubbles. Push the sled and you can slide down with ease. We took out the lightning shield. Not a whole lot to say about this level again. Catchy music. Don't really care for the background. The background actually was a lot better in my opinion. I'm going to use Tails to fly over there because I don't really want to risk jumping and not making it. This is actually the first level in the Sonic 3 part that has bottomless pits. There are no bottomless pits in the first act. Depending on the route you take in Act 2, you will encounter bottomless pits. And that's the casino one, so we will not bother with that. We have 300 rings. Can we actually beat the mini-boss without losing our rings? Let's find out. This machine will surround itself with snowballs. It kind of acts similar to that of the Metropolis boss in Sonic 2, except, well, you know, it just throws snowballs at you. Dodge snowballs and you should be alright. Take 6 hits to kill, of course. Just duck and make sure you don't get hit by his rotating snowballs. And you're seeing a preview of the background. And unfortunately, you got hit by that. You're seeing a preview of the background for Act 2. And all we need to do is actually hit him. Let's fly up. Let's time our flying correctly. Not like that, of course. And I fucked up, because... yeah, no, there's no excuse there. Oh well, we defeated him anyways. I tried to hit him, but for some reason I did not, you know... I did not go in the direction I wanted to. I flew right above him. Which is unfortunate. But oh well. It's time for Act 2 of Ice Cap Zone. I love the background here. It's like the Antarctica background type. Water in the background with platforms of ice. Yeah. There is a bottom path you can take, and there is a special stage ring you can access in the bottom part of the act, but I'm not sure if I'll get to show it off. There is water here, but again, it's in the bottom part, so. I love the music. The music is very catchy. Damn good. Now, like Carnival Night Zone, I've never been able to beat the second act boss without losing rings. So maybe we can continue the streak from Carnival Night Zone's boss and beat this boss without losing rings. It's pretty difficult for me, though. So we're gonna go on the bottom part. Yes, we are. There is water here! Let me show it off. And there is a special stage ring you can get. Do not fall down here because there's a bottomless pit. Like I said, this is the first zone in the game that actually has bottomless pits. It's the only one in Sonic 3 and Knuckles that does. I mean, Sonic 3 that is. Not Sonic 3 and Knuckles. The only level in the Sonic 3 portion that has bottomless pits. Unless you count the bottomless pits when you face the first boss of the game, but I'm not really counting that, because that's just a boss fight. Probably shouldn't have lost, went out of my way to show you guys the ring, because I just lost my shield. Whoa, I didn't think I would get hit by him, but I lost all my rings, so GGB. There is an area in this level with a bunch of rings. Unless you're Tails or Knuckles, you might want a lightning shield to get to it. Let me show it off. And that's not how we're gonna show it off. I can fly up there because I'm Tails. It's kinda cheap, but I do wanna show off all these areas that you can get to. Yeah, there's a shitload of rings here they can get to. Yeah, Tails does get tuckered out while he's flying. So I do want to watch out for that. At the end of this video, I will, of course, be showing off Sonic riding the snowboard in Act 1. I believe I hit this. Yeah, I hit the checkpoint already, so I can't really get a shield now, can I? Which means we definitely are gonna lose our rings. Unless there's another checkpoint up here, I'm not really sure. Nope! Alright, well, prepare to lose our rings. I said that in the last video, but I'm being serious here. Dr. Robotnik or Dr. Eggman will be riding a. His machine! It'll spit out some cool air, which will freeze you. So, yeah, once you get frozen, you cannot escape. Just try to dodge them. I'm not sure if there's a specific pattern. Yeah. I don't think there's a pattern. So, there's an example of very careful here. Yep, I told you I was not going to beat this boss without losing rings. Dude, this is tough. And I think we're going to die. Our second death of the game. Woohoo! Yep, we're dead. That's such a cheap boss. Let's redeem ourselves, hopefully. We should be able to get an extra life, though, so we can recover that life. A life that we lost very easily. Yes, we will, because the special stage... Oh, no, I don't think the special stage ring responds. Even after you collect the Chaos Emeralds. Yeah, alright. We're not going to recover that extra life, sadly. Well, rip. Alright, let's try this again. Takes 8 heads to kill, of course. I really can't get used to the pattern on it. I fucking hate this boss! Like, I'm not even joking! This boss is so unfair! Freaking can't even escape. There's like too much frost breath in this thing. Alright, for the final phase, he'll lose his platform and the stink that'll just come at you. He should kill this boss. Damn, that was unfair. Sorry, I was really focused on the boss. So we beat Ice Cap Zone. Now we're gonna go to the final zone of the Sonic 3 portion, that'll be Launch Base. Fun fact, there's actually a trick you can do here. To sit right here, you stay in spin dash formation, and a bunch of enemies will just fly into you, and you can get points that way and get extra lives. So let me just show you an example. Keep getting those points. Obviously, I'm not gonna keep doing it for the whole level, for the whole video, but I'm just gonna showcase what I mean. Like I said, every 50,000 points you get an extra life, so here we go. Yep. A nice way to cheese the game and get infinite lives and get hit by that stupid ass bird thing. I think there's a special ring down here. There is! Special stage ring. These things will crush you, by the way. And I don't know why I jumped right into that. That was pretty stupid. Basically, in the background, you can see Dr. Eggman's Death Egg Ship. Spoiler alert! Yeah, it's basically Dr. Eggman's launch base that you're in. You're infiltrating it. There's another special stage ring over here, so grab that, get 50 rings, or enter special stage if you haven't already gotten all the Chaos Emeralds. This will be your last this will be your last chance to get the Chaos Emeralds. And you'll see why when we get to the next level. Alright, so I'm trying to be very careful here. We'll see how many extra lives I can hoard before the end of the game. There's another one of these enemies that are similar to that of Sonic 1's Labyrinth Zone enemy. These guys will not shoot their spike balls at you, so you can't really kill them unless you have invincibility, or if you want to lose your ring, so don't even try. I hate these frogs that have, like, weights on them. Pretty annoying to take down. Again, the background's pretty cool. The music, it's alright. I'm not really that much of a fan of. The music is fine, I guess. Might be my first choice. And this isn't my least favorite level, by the way. It's Carnival Night does. Watch out for those laser shoots, and we're not going to jump into the casino bonus stage because we don't need to. It's just not worth it, in my opinion. These guys do not hurt you, but hitting them will take away obstacles. So to proceed, you're going to have to kill them. I'm being very careful here, and I just got launched into the stupid spring. Fantastic. Things are going very well for us in this level, if you can't already tell. I'm not exactly sure how you get to those, ring boxes. I cannot believe we lost a ring. This is a stupid spring. And I just keep failing! I really suck at this game, but it's alright. I'm not trying to get I'm not trying to be perfect, because I know I can't. Dash through here and there'll be a launch. Which I wonder what this does. Ugh, my hate getting hit. And here's a fire shield and a ring box. So at least we can get protection from losing our ring. One hit. There's so many springs! Like I said, there are some differences between Knuckles and the Sonic storyline, so we'll be going over those when we get to the Knuckles storyline, of course. We'll be for another few more levels, because still gotta beat the Sonic and Knuckles portion of the game. And here you can find a water shield. You can also find this guy trying to trick you. Be careful not to get squashed. There is a bottomless pit you can fall down in this level, but it's not until the boss, or near the boss, so I don't have to worry about that. I say watch out, make sure you don't get squashed, I almost did. I actually want to get those ring boxes, so I'm going to just spin that up the slope and hopefully reach it. That'd be awesome. I'll just fly up there. Doesn't really matter. Awesome. Just missed out on a gumball bonus stage, but that's fine. Gumball machine one. Alright, there's Dr. Robotnik. He'll flee from you. Go jump on these cups, I guess. And here's Knuckles. Knuckles will throw a bomb down below. It'll actually create a bottomless pit. So you fall down there, you're gonna die, obviously. So best not to do that. Now, we'll just be here watching the building collapse. And no, you cannot go into the bottle state. You can try, but there's an invisible wall blocking it, which is weird, because why would Dr. Robotnik prevent you from trying to kill yourself? Let's go in the gumball machine one. We haven't done that in a while. Get ourselves an extra life. The shields don't really benefit you in this boss fight, because there's no projectiles being launched at you. There's really no benefit to, making the gumball machine go to the bottom. And we are going to our boss. This machine will be rotating with spikes around it. Just wait until the spikes stay in one place and just hit it on the side. Every three hits, one of the spikes will disappear. One of the spiky arms. Hit it six times, and you should defeat it. I'll just hit this sign, see if we can get some goodies out of it. We can't, but we'll just fly up here. And we'll pose on top of the block. Pretty long level, if I do say so myself, but, you know. Now, there is water in this level, so we won't be seeing our... We'll be losing our... Like a shield right now, as a matter of fact. Like I said, the Sonic 3 game is water heavy. Lots of water sections in it. Pretty much every level in Sonic 3 has water in it, except for Marble Garden Zone. Angel Island has water. Hydro City has, well, it's the water level of the game. Carnival Night has some water in it. Ice Cap Zone is water, although you don't really have to go into the water in Ice Cap Zone. But there's water there! So yeah. And Launch Beast has it as well. Glitch for there, which is interesting. But yeah, water sections galore in Sonic 3. The Sonic 3 and Knuckles portion of the game, the Sonic and Knuckles portion of the game, excuse me, there is no water to be found. It's like there's a drought. And I just jump right into the fire, which is awesome. Actually, I think there's a special stage ring in here. Yes, there is. I remember there being one. Nothing okay. Be super careful. The momentum of the spring will take you over the cup, so I'll just fly into it. Jump on these swings, here and you'll find it installs a water shield. The shields are not going to really benefit you in the boss either, but they're there to protect you from losing rings for one time. If you were Knuckles, you would be able to get through here just by walking, but you cannot even spin dash with Sonic or Tails. There is a fire shield up here. Yes, there is. We'll grab it because why not? I think I'm going to regret that decision. Now let's go to the glowing spears one, because why not? Let's get some nice goodies before we reach the final boss of the Sonic 3 portion of the game. But that's basically Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles combined, hence the name Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Not a lot to say about it. I really do enjoy playing the game, but it is very long. It's a very long game. We're gonna approach the boss very soon. Let's just get this ring box on top. Because why not? I just have a habit of getting them. Like, Dr. Eggman will be in a pod. He will launch a platform and shoot cannonballs at him. So what you wanna do is jump. Hit him 8 times. And get hit. Steals egg pod. You'll drive the egg pod towards the next section of the next boss. However, Knuckles is gonna stop you. He's on top of a pillar. He'll punch you. He'll just block you until Dr. Eggman launches his ship, and unfortunately, Knuckles falls. So, that's some karma for Knuckles teaming up with Dr. Eggman. I can't get used to saying Dr. Robotnik. You know, that's what his name is in this game. So, Dr. Robotnik is launching his rocket. You're gonna jump on a platform, and you're gonna fight him. If you were playing just Sonic the Hedgehog 3, there'd be another boss after this one. Basically, he'll just bring a rocket down, it'll shoot lasers and have a spike ball surrounding it. Pretty easy to defeat. There will be another boss if you were just playing Sonic the Hedgehog 3, like I just mentioned, but we are not, so we beat Launch Beast Zone. The platform is going to explode, it's going to detach from the rocket, and you're going to be sent down. You're also going to see the death egg, I believe, fall in the background. Or maybe, yeah, you're going to see the death egg fall in the background, which will be a part of the storyline later on. So next time on Let's Play Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Knuckles, we will explore the Sonic and Knuckles portion of the game. See you then.